Hello everyone, welcome back to Java for Our course. In today's class, we are going to learn about different type of errors that you may encounter intentionally or unintentionally. In Java, or for that matter, any programming language, right? Every programming language has its set of rules, what I call it a grammar of the language. For example, when we speak English, we use comma, we use full stop, we use some connector words like and, or, but, all these, you know, what we call it as grammar of the language. So Java also has its own grammar. We talked in the last class that in Java, we use curly braces to identify or create a block of statements. Any statement we write at the end, we put semicolon. All these are what we call it the syntax or conforming to the grammar of Java. Now, if you make a mistake like this, suppose you forgot to put curly braces at the end, or you forgot to write, you know, semicolon at the end, these are called syntactical error. Syntactical errors are usually caught by compilers. Remember, when we write our code, this code is fed into a compiler, and compiler runs your code and creates an intermediate language in Java, right? And that ultimately gets converted into machine language. Now, this compiler prevents you from converting your code into an intermediate language. The reason is your code is not conforming or not complying with the grammar of Java. And as you progress in this class, you will learn a lot about different type of syntaxes, some of the reserve words that you cannot use in different contexts. Those things, we will learn, and those are any mistake you make in that area is referred as syntax errors. Good code editors highlight those errors as you type. Earlier, if you write even today, when you write this code in a text editor, like a notepad, and you compile it using Java compiler will give you a list of errors. But the code editors have become smarter. When you type your code, it will show you as and when you type any syntactical error. You really don't need to wait to compile the code. But again, if you ignore those warnings, if you don't fix it in the code editor, and you continue to write code and then compile, of course, compiler is going to complain. Now, the second type of error, you will see what I call it logical error. Logical errors are those that prevents you from getting the right result. So there is no problem in your code. You give the code to the compiler or to Java. Java executes the code for you, gives back the result, but then result is not what you would expect. For example, we all know how to calculate simple interest. So if I take simple interest, we know that interest is calculated using if I is nothing but principal, rate of interest, and time divided by 100. Right? Now this time has to be in years. Suppose you forgot that this time is not in years and you forgot to convert that into years, and now you use it month, then the interest you get, output you get, it is wrong. And in the programming world, you have to remember that you feed wrong data, you get wrong results. But it's not about feeding the wrong data here. It's actually the logic that you should have converted it into years before you apply this formula. So that's called a logical error. You get the Java will not complain. For Java, it's our responsibility to, write the logic, whatever. As long as whatever we have written, Java will execute it. So if we write it, if we write our logic incorrectly, Java will give you wrong result. So that's referred as logical error. And then finally, there is something called runtime error. Runtime error is when you, as I said, you have a block of code. We write here our code, we feed this into Java compiler. Compiler is goes into intermediate language, that gets into machine language. Machine language is thus where computer is going to execute your program. An idea is to save ourselves from getting those errors or mistakes later, which computer will identify for us. So we want to catch the error or mistake as early as possible. If you catch it at this level, we call it compilation error. If you If you don't get the right output, then we call it as logical errors. But if errors which machine can't handle, for example, you divide a number by zero. So we are trying to calculate the, you know, the rate of interest. I wouldn't say rate of interest. Let's say, suppose you want to calculate the velocity, or, you know, we say time, the distance divided by time, distance divided by time. Suppose in this case, time is zero, then the velocity is incorrect. Your system will not be able to compute. The computer will not be able to compute your velocity because the time is incorrect. The time cannot be zero. Your denominator cannot be zero. So that type of error is what we call it, refer as runtime error. In that case, your program will exit, your program will crash, and you know, you will not be able to get any output because you cannot divide any number by zero, right? Why will you put it zero? Because you're writing a formula, and in some cases, you know, the way the input is given, it is possible that time will be, you know, since time is a calculated value, then time may calculate and become zero, and in that case, you know, your program will not run. So that's called logical, you know, the runtime error. I hope you understand all three types of errors. I'll see you guys in the next class. Happy learning. Bye-bye.